chance for peace snuffed out by sudden, terrifying violence. The activists had gathered in Turkey's capital to call for an end to fighting between the government and the PKK, only to find themselves the victims of a horrific attack. One of the worst in Turkey's history. Dozens killed, hundreds wounded.
Normal, edebi kitlesi kortej halindeydi.
There was a demonstration. I was walking next to a stage rally truck. Right here, behind two banners, an explosion went off. We lay on the ground. The second bomb went off there. There were two bombs, but the one that went off here was a very strong one.
This is the third attack to target pro-Kurdish activists since June. In July, dozens were killed when a suicide bomber struck in Suruj on Turkey's border with Syria. Since then, the security situation in Turkey has deteriorated sharply. With the peace process between the government and the PKK having all but collapsed. Prime Minister Ahmet Davutoglu called for 3 days of mourning while discussing initial findings. But these deadly blasts outside Ankara's train station underscore just how tense the situation remains before November's snap parliamentary elections.
There are still investigators, forensic investigators, on the scene searching for evidence. In fact, all around the train station, you can still see the remnants of the tragic blast. Here are peace signs next to bloodstains on the road.
I'm sure I will never forget the things I lived today. Actually, it was like hell. The 1st of November, there is a big election in Turkey. And we want them to stop and to decrease the tension of Turkey.
For now, though, even amid this heightened security, and these emptied streets, it's the shock that is most evident of all. Mohammed Jamjoum, Al Jazeera, Ankara, Turkey.